What's up guys, it's Voske Sharp here, and we all know that one of the hardest gold camos to get is the gold camo for the Joker. Well, I found a way to get it in one day if you use my tips. I have done the challenge much longer though, because I did not know all of this, but I will give you my knowledge so you can get it fast and efficient. In this video I will show you the best class setups to use and which killstreaks to focus on and how many rockets it takes out to take out a killstreak. But before we start the video, please do me a favor by dropping a like and please subscribe if you're new to my channel. Without further ado, let's roll in the intro. If you are here for a specific camo, then I made it very easy for you because I made timestamps in the timeline so you can skip ahead to where you want. We are gonna go through each camo one by one and I will tell you how I completed all of the 100 camo challenges fast and efficient. First of all, if you want to do the Joker gold camo challenges, make sure to always use the Joker as your secondary to level it up much faster, or use level up tokens. But first, here you see in the background how much rockets it's needed to take out any killstreak. And there are a few killstreaks you can melee down and it will also count towards the challenges. There are some killstreaks you shouldn't even have to try, and some can be taken out, for example the advanced UV, because it's too far away to take out. Now for the class setup that you need to use during this journey. As a primary weapon you can use whatever you prefer. If you're going for the Damascus camo, then use a gun to unlock those camo challenges too. As perks you need to use Cold Blooded and Spotter. The second perk you can choose whatever you prefer, but I do recommend Ghost. Why Cold Blooded you think? Well, AI streaks can shoot you down. AI streaks are sentry guns, VTOL and support helo, and that's a huge help when you need to shoot down a VTOL for example and it doesn't kill you right away. And for the perk Spotter, it comes in very handy when you're going for the challenges because you will get a red outline over the enemy killstreak, streaks, equipment, and field upgrades. It especially helps when enemy UAVs are called in because you don't need to look for the UAV, you can spot it right away because of the red outline. Now we're gonna go through each camo challenges. In the top left corner you will see the camo and which game modes are best for it. For the first camo, the spray paint, you will need to make 125 kills. This is the most easy one, so you don't have to focus on this one because it will come eventually while grinding for the other camos. But the best game mode for this one is hardcore shipment because it's fast and efficient and it can be done in a few games. And in the background you are seeing the best spots to do this on shipment, where you will need to stand and where you will need to shoot, because shipment is gonna help you a lot getting the gold camo for the Joker, and you will use this game mode for most of the camos. First of all, hardcore is a good game mode to get the kills because the explosives will do more damage, and because shipment is very small you will always get a kill. Woodland is 40 attacker kills, and this one can be combined with the digital camo that needs 40 defender kills. For example, if the enemy is on the hardpoint and you get a kill, it will count towards both of these camos. I got this one almost in one game. As I'm showcasing in the background, you see that I only got 3 kills with both camos. In the meantime, I skip on forward. I hopped in a match of hardcore shipment. What I do recommend for this camo, if there is hardcore domination or hardpoint, then you're good to go, because these two are game modes where you can get the progress for both camos at the same time. As you can see, now I played at, and this was after the game where I got 35 kills for both camos. And as you saw, I made a big progression with the reptile camo too. So in one game I made a big progression for 3 camos at the same time. To complete Dragon, all you need to do is to destroy 75 airstreaks. This one is very easy to do, just play ground war and spawn at the beginning of the map. Use the perk Spotter to spot all the airstreaks right away because there will be a UV every few seconds. If you're out of ammo and you don't care about your KD, just throw lethal and kill yourself to spawn back with enough ammo to start over again. The next camo is one of the hardest camos to get, and that's the Splinter camo. I made a video about this especially for the Splinter camo where I go more in depth. If you want to see that, just click here in the top right or the first link in the description. But to unlock the Splinter camo, you need to destroy 75 ground based vehicles or kill streaks. So the ground streaks are the tanks in ground war, shield turret, sentry gun, Wilson, personal UVs, counter UVs, VTOL jet and the attack helicopter. The best way to get this fast is to focus a lot on the personal UVs, as these are the most easy one to destroy and they deploy much often. Watch the video where I go more in depth about the Splinter camo, where I also explain how to target down more personal UVs. To unlock the Topo camo, you will need to destroy 50 killstreaks, equipment or vehicles with the Spotter perk. If you're using the Spotter perk at all time while going for the other challenges, then you will see that this one comes eventually, so you don't have to focus on this one. To complete Tiger, you will need to destroy 50 support streaks. These are the personal UVs, UVs, and the counter UVs. Since people use the UV at all time, you can get this one while going for the other challenges, because it is an easy one, as of all support streaks can go down by one rocket. To complete Stripes, you need to destroy 50 streaks with the perk Cold Blooded. Just use the perk Cold Blooded at all time, and while you're going for the other challenges, this will come eventually. Reptile has 50 kills with the perk Amped. Just use the perk Amped for 1 or 2 games on hardcore shipment and you're good to go, as you can get a lot of kills on shipment, and the kills are easy to get because of the hardcore mode, and you will get this one in 1 or 2 games. Destroy 50 vehicles to unlock the Skrulls camo. The vehicles are ATVs, the cars, the tactical rovers, the helicopters and the tanks in ground war. However, the enemy has to drive in it, or it had to be a neutral vehicle somewhere on the map. If it spawns in your spawn and you destroy it, it will not count towards the Skrulls camo. Only if it spawns somewhere on the map, then it will count towards Skrulls camo when you destroy it. And if you unlock the Skrulls camo, you will finally unlock the hardest camo of the game, the gold camo for the Joker. Make sure to always use the Joker as your secondary if you're going for the gold camo, and try to combine the challenges. For example, if you get 50 kills in one game in objective game mode with the perks Cold Blooded and Amped, you will unlock 4 challenges at the same time. So try to combine the challenges to get fast and efficient progression and unlock the Joker within one day. That's it for this video. I hope this guide helped you out, or you just enjoyed watching it. If it was one of those two, then please drop a like and please subscribe to support my channel. And let me know in the comments if you got any questions surrounding this guide for the Joker. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.